turkey or pizzeria, but the teacup is little. You wouldn't want that. That little thing, you kill it. You know
no,
how many times
don't,
it creeps up on you?
We don't want a dog.
No, I know you don't.
Because
we're going to have a baby!
Get out! It's our baby!
Yeah, man. That's how it looks. Your baby is growing up a storm. This week, measuring about half an inch. Wow, that much.
I am my way to the doctor's appointment. We had a little issue this morning. They had to reschedule me earlier, so we had to schedule everything around to make this appointment, but we didn't want to wait till Wednesday because that's the next appointment. It is Friday, it's a long weekend. We need to get this done now. So my friend Jovanka, beautiful woman, she's helping out in this. So I'm nervous, I have a stomach ache, and here we go. Oh my God. We gotta capture this moment.
No, I look horrible.
It's recording, too late.
Stop, Grace, here, you.
She came to the doctor with me. Who does that? I don't know who would do that. I would do that for someone. You see, but God connected me with someone who has the same heart as I do.
I look cross-eyed.
I look like I haven't slept, so we're okay.
Okay.
How do you feel?
I'm gonna list everything.
You what?
I'm gonna list everything I feel right now.
Go ahead,
yes.
Spit it out, wrap
it.
Come on.
I feel disgusted, sweaty, and tired. I'm so sleepy, I can't even deal with it.
I'm not talking about that.
I was trying to rap.
He was about to like break into like.
I was gonna cry.
A big a rapper.
Right
oh
no.
No.
No, I'm kidding.
I told you it's early pregnancy. You can see that little white line, that's an embryo.
Yeah? You only see one, right?
Yes. Kind of in the lower segment of the uterus, you can see cervix is right here.
It's right there, right?
Yes. But the top of the uterus is here, and the cavity is, we prefer that it be a little bit higher. It's a slightly low-lying pregnancy, okay?
Yes, sir.
We'll keep an eye over it. I mean, it's too soon for us to know one way or other. It's very early. You are measuring 0.4, so probably about 5 weeks and a change.
5 weeks?
Yeah, so we're going to do some blood work. I want you to come back next week again, next July 5th. Okay?
Okay.
We'll do one more ultrasound to see what's going on.
Is that moving?
So some flickering there. Difficult to say. this is the embryos. So next week, you know, hopefully we'll see a little better.
Okay.
Only thing that concerning right now is two things.
Okay.
You can see this is the cervix. It's lying, the pregnancy is lying in the lower part of the uterus. Sometimes it can go up and you'll be okay. This is the, see this? It should be somewhere here. It's kind of low, but it still can go up. So keep an eye over it. It's a low implantation. This is your cervix. The real uterus is somewhere here.
Okay.
So it probably will move. Next week when we do ultrasound, there could be just like a small fiber here.
Okay.
So next week my technician will be here. And look, this plane, you look okay. So let's see what we get. Trying to see if I can see any flickering there. There's no embryonic activity yet. You can see that, but I don't see how it's going to flicker. So we definitely want you to come back in 1 week.
Friend is coming with me again to the doctor. Better than she is.
Oh my god.
Who's better than she is?
By now we should see heartbeat. The fact that we are not looking at heartbeat and
during the ministry, it's a lot to carry as a woman because all these things start going through your head, you know. I never looked at myself as a person that couldn't have kids. I never had that idea in my head. I never saw or believe that other people said, oh, you know, she's barren, she can't have kids. I never even thought about that, but all these thoughts were coming into my head. I can't carry. And so it's a lot to carry when you feel like the doctor's telling you on one side there's no life in you. also don't even love on this baby. And then there's another part of you that's telling you there is life in there. There is life. I just started to cry in church. And I started to release that with a cry, with a wailing. And Chester heard me and he said, let's go up to the front and pray. We went up to the front and I was just leaving all there to God. That his will be done no matter what. He's gonna get the glory out of all of this. And who says that, you know, unless you know who your God is. And the pastor came and he prayed for us and that was so beautiful. And it broke me when he started to cry, my own pastor, because he was there when I lost the baby the first time. My husband gave out this cry from deep in his heart, the only way he knew how, and it was singing. And he just released it in the air, and that was it for me. That was it for me, because it's something, it's one thing that I cry and release, but it's another thing to see your husband, a man. It just broke me, and I'm like, God, you're gonna do something wonderful and supernatural in this. I threw myself on the floor, my husband threw himself in the altar, and we just left it all there. Everything that I was feeling, everything that I was carrying, I left it there for God to take care of it, to handle it, to do it the way He knows best. And prayed. When I got this message on my inbox asking for prayer, now this is when you see what you're made of. I myself needed some encouraging words, but I put myself on the side and gave her words of wisdom, whatever the Lord put in my heart. And then I continue on my journey.